Hey guys, I don't know how this one's going to turn out because I'm doing this one off my phone because my camera's in use right now uploading another video I just did. Actually, the camera's not. It's the D-SIM card that is. But I've got some really weird angles going on here. I got a 60 degree angle. I've got a 30 degree angle. And then over on the other wall over there, I've got two 45 degree angles. And I decided, you know what, these are a real pain to try to do freehand. As you can see, I've already worked on this 30 degree angle down this length here. It's really hard to play with, and I've still got the 60 degree angle to do. So this was my solution. I have an angle finder, and I just did that totally wrong. I did it on the wrong section. But what I did is I took my angle finder, I tipped it at an angle, I found a 30 degree special point that I needed to play with, I tightened it down, and then I used the inside edge to try to use that to draw some lines. All right, here's the purpose of these lines. Let me get down off the tree. We're standing on the scaffolding here, but everything on top makes it a little hard. This is what I did using this angle finder. By coming up with the right angles, that one was a 30 degree angle that I just did. I found the center of the trowel, marked it off with a marker. I got the 30, I got the 45, and I got the 60. Bought new knives to do this with. And I just set my break up off the scaffolding, which is really funny because I have to hold the scaffolding down in order to make it hold right. But I bought these knives special just to do all these three different angles. Now what got me invested in the idea that I should probably do that was that you can go to the store and buy the 90 degree. You can go into a 90 degree, hit these outside edge corners, go in, hit all these top corners and stuff where it's 90 degrees, and be able to use that knife to be able to clean them up. And there's a lot of them that went all the way down the length of the width of the shed here. So I decided, hey, you know what? If that works for that, why can't I make that work for me by just buying three more knives and bending those knives to do the same job that that 90 degree angle did? And you know what? I am really, really sure, and yes, I did. I labeled it right on each one of them. 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees. I marked them off, I brought them over to the break, I bent them out, I did what I needed to do to make them be what they can be. I wish they would have been a little farther, but they're not bad, they work. And that's how I plan on finishing all the drywall around here. That bucket of mud right there is down to maybe about, it's less than a quarter of a bucket now. Probably about a sixth of a bucket. So I had to go out and buy one more bucket because I know I'm going through an awful lot of mud on this stuff. Oh yeah, and this is the floor right here in these boxes, and it's beautiful. I can't wait to start putting that down, but I have to finish the ceiling up here. There's still a little bit of work to do on the ceiling, get it sanded down, do a finish coat on all of that. But I got it all in except for the outside edges, which that's what the 90 degree knife is for. And on the 45 for these two corners here. But yeah, I'm planning on really working hard on this one now because I've come up with a game plan and I hope it works. Again, it's been an adventure by all means, but I think with these four knives, it's gonna happen and it's gonna happen really, really quick now. This is my goal. Talk to you in a bit.